The Office of the Solicitor General under fire for its participation in the Justice Department's probe into the sedition complaint against Vice President Leni Robredo, former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV, and other opposition figures. Assistant Solicitor General Angelita Miranda appeared at Friday's preliminary investigation to represent the Philippine National Police Criminal Investigation and Detection Group, which lodged the complaint. The OSG's presence questioned by the camp of former senatorial candidate Chel Jokno. Miranda defended her office's participation as the government's lawyer and tribune of the people, which former Senator Rene Sagisag, lawyer for Senator Risa Ontiveros, quickly rebutted.
OSG, tribune of the people, no? Hindi tuta ng Malacanang. Kaya dito, in the end, they may even move for our acquittal or dismissal ang kaso. So it should not sandbag itself into becoming a defender of the attempt of the administration to eliminate all dissent and dissenters.
ABS-CBN News first reported the OSG's involvement in the drafting of Advincula's affidavit, which the office justified as rendering legal assistance to its client, the PNP-CIDG.
Kami kung bakit nakikialam ang Solgen dito sa kaso namin eh. Alam naman natin na hindi pangkaraniwang ginagawa nila yan. At we don't know why we are being given that kind of special treatment by the Office of the Solicitor General.
In a statement, the OSG denounced Sagisag's language as gutter talk, which spills beyond the walls of decency and propriety. It also insisted the mandate of the OSG as principal law officer and legal defender of the government under the administrative code is broad. But for former Solicitor General Florine Hilbay, the OSG's charter limits its authority in criminal cases to representing the government in the Court of Appeals and the Supreme Court.
Nung tayo po ay Solicitor General, hindi ko naisip na makialam sa investigation on criminal matters. Dahil yung power ng OSG in criminal cases is limited dun sa appeals.
Free Legal Assistance Group lawyers Jokno, Erin Tanyada, Philip Sawali, and former Supreme Court spokesperson Theodore Temeinwal questioned the Justice Secretary's legal basis for convening a panel of prosecutors, given that the case does not involve national security or probable miscarriage of justice. Only 10 out of the more than 30 respondents attended Friday's probe. Robredo, Trillanes, and Ontiveros were represented by their lawyers. According to the prosecutors, 15 of the respondents filed motions either seeking to suspend the probe or defer the submission of their counter-affidavits until after the CIDG is able to present all its evidence. They assert their rights to due process will be violated if they are not informed of the entirety of the allegations and evidence against them. The DOJ prosecutors gave CIDG 5 days to furnish respondents with their additional evidence, while respondents are tentatively required to submit their counter-affidavits by September 6. For now, only 5 respondents have submitted counter-affidavits denying the allegations. They include Lingayen Archbishop Socrates Villegas, Caloocan Bishop Pablo Virgilio David, and retired Novaliches Bishop Teodoro Bacani Jr. Mike Navallo, ABS-CBN News.